we have gone through a full scan architecture and partial scan architecture of a scan design. So today we'll see a random access scan architecture. So there are three types of scan design architecture: full scan architecture, partial scan architecture, and the random access scan architecture. We have seen in a full scan architecture, advantage of full scan architecture is not required a sequential ATPG to generate a test pattern. Combinational ATPG can work for a full scan design. But the disadvantage of full scan architecture is area overhead due to converting all the storage element into a scannable flip-flops or a scan cell, right? So area overhead plus performance degradation due to the once we convert any storage element into a scan cell, it add a 2x1 mux, and that comes the between the 2D flip-flops, and whatever the delay between the 2D flip-flops, that is important in any sequential design. So it add that delay. So suppose it's add in a critical path, then it degrade the performance of the design. In a partial full scan, partial scan architecture, we are converting a selective storage element into the scan cell. So to avoid the performance degradation in a full scan design, only some selective storage element which are not in a critical path, so they these storage element you have to convert into the scan cell. So it improves the performance compared to the full scan design, but due to the partial scan, after the scan design, after the DMP insertion for a testing purpose, still the storage element which not replaced into the scan cell, it make the circuit have a sequential circuit, right? And for that required a sequential ATPG to generate a test pattern. So that have its own that pros and cons of the full scan design and the partial scan design. In both the scan design architecture, to load the internal node with the desired logic level or to observe the internal node, we have to that data is passed through the scan chain. It create a chain of a scan cell and it prepared a shift in shift out types of shift register. So we need to be wait that many clock cycle to observe the internal node or to load the internal node. So that's in the full scan design as well as in the partial scan design. But in the random access scan design, we can access any scan cell directly, right? So it prepared a structure like a memory. So any scan cell directly we can access. Suppose there are a different scan cell. So it create a row and column decoder. So it have the row and column decoder. So through this row and column decoder, it identify particular scan cell and directly we can read it without preparing a chain of scan cell, right? So here it is like a structure of a memory. So directly we can read any particular scan cell through this column and this row decoder addressing. So can control or observe the individual scan cell without affecting others, right? Not to prepare in a chain, and so without affecting the others, directly we can read any particular scan cell. Also we can control the particular scan cell. Reduce the test power dissipation. Reducing means, suppose if you want to set here, not need to pass the data shifting by one, directly we can set, right? simplify the process of performing the delay test. Disadvantage of traditional RS are the high overhead in scan design routing. So if I want to access any particular scan cell, I need a column line and the this row and column lines. So it added the that extra that this routing is required, right? That different column for different rows line, this is required. So it overhead in a routing. No guarantee to reduce the test application time. So that's advantage and disadvantage of the random access scan design. So you can see here, it have the column decoder and row decoder. These are the extra routing is required to for the column and row, right? Extra routing are required. Now next topic is scan design rule. Scan design rule. So we cannot directly convert any design into a scannable design, means by not just by replacing all the storage element into a scan cell. We cannot do like for all the design. We need to how to follow some rules, right? So that are the scan design rule. So scan design rule for tri-state buffer. So if the design have the tri-state buffer, and this tri-state that bus it drive through a multiple tri-state buffer, then when we convert such design into a scannable design, right, then we have to avoid during the shifting. We have to avoid the tri-state buffer during the shifting operation. And the recommended solution is fix the bus contention during the shift. We are going to see each this scan design rule in a detail with the example, right? So do not worry. This is just the list out of different design style and what is the recommended solution when we convert the design into a scannable design. Yes? Okay. So next is, suppose have any bidirectional I/O port in the design, then we have to avoid that bidirectional I/O port during the shifting operation. And how we can avoid this bidirectional I/O port during the shifting operation is to force the input or output mode during the shifting operations. Then suppose the design have a gated clock. You know what is the gated clock? Gated clock is suppose clock is ended due to the ending with some enable signal, right? So suppose this is enable and here it is my clock. So if my clock is AND with some enable signal, so whenever enable is equal to 1, then it's it will get output of AND gate is clock, and when enable is equal to 0, there is no clock, right? So gated clock, it is normally used to reduce the power consumptions, right? So unnecessary, there is no switching here in this durations. So whenever we not required any switching, then it by doing this gated clock, it that ending with this enable signal, and here there is a no clock. So there is no clock, that's mean no switching, and the no switching, that's means the in a CMOS design there is no power dissipation, right? We know in a CMOS design power dissipation is occur only when there is having a switching, because in CMOS there is no static power dissipation. So power dissipation is only due to the dynamic or switching power dissipation. And how we can avoid the switching? So unnecessary switching, right? Whenever we not required any clocking, or whenever output is not going to change, then we do not need to be do some unnecessary switching. So that can be avoided by doing the clock with the enable signal. It is called a clocked gating. So this is another good concept that you should know, what is the gated clock. So gated clock is useful in a design to save the power. But it is once we convert this design into a scannable design, then we have to avoid the gated clock, because in a shifting also it create a problem, right? So avoid during the shifting operation. And how we can avoid it? By doing the enable clock during the shifting. Derived clock. Gated clock and derived clock. Derived clock is means the clock output is depend on the others signals, output of others functions, right? So it is called a gated clock. So it should be avoided in the skin design and bypass that such clock when converting to the skin design. Combinational feedback loop, that should be avoided, and asynchronous synchronous feedback loop, clock driving data, floating buses, floating input, cross couple and a NOR gate, non-scan storage elements. So these are this different design style and what is the solution when we convert that design into a scannable design. See one by one. So this is first a tri-state buses, right? So in the design have the tri-state bus, and this all the tri-state, it is driving a single bus. This is a bus which is drive by D1, it is also drive by D2, also it driving by D3. So it should be avoided in a shifting mode. So how we can avoid it? So bus contention occur when two bus drive the force opposite logic value onto a tri-state buffer. Now suppose our aim is to, suppose I want to load SFF1 with the 1 logic, SFF2 with the 0 logic, and SFF3 with the 1 logic. This is our target that we want to load with this desired logic value, right? So how we can load is by giving the signal from the SI, right, at every clock. So at every clock, this SI is shifted and it is loaded. So suppose I will give 1. So in first clock cycle, this 1 will appear here. And this is the input to the next, right? And at the second clock cycle, if I give the 0, then 0 will come here. And this 1 is transferred here. And this 0 will be the input. And at the third clock cycle, this one will be the one will be the transfer here, 0 will be the here, and this new one will be the transfer here, right? So we'll get here it is 1, here it is 0, and here it is 1. So if I give this to the tri-state buffer, then this tri-state buffer is also enabled, and this D3 is also enabled, right? So D3 and D1 both are driving, tri-state buffer are enabled. And suppose here the input of tri-state, suppose here the input is logic 1, and here also suppose input is logic 0, then this bus it drive with the two opposite logic. So here this is also enabled because of this enable line is 1. So this is driving the bus with the logic 1, and this D3 tri-state buffer is drive the bus with the logic 0. So here two opposite logic, this is driving with the two opposite logic, and this should be avoided during the shifting. Right? Because in shifting, what we want to load that we don't know. So during this designing, they have a design such a way that this enable signal, two enable signal never comes equal. At a time only one enable signal is 1. It designed such a way that at a time only one enable signal is 1. So it not driving this bus not face any problems of driving with two opposite logic. But this is happen when we are shifting the data, when we are operating this design in a shifting mode, then it's create a problem. So it should be avoided in a shifting mode. Hope it is clear. Samjhan hua? What is the problems in a tri-state that driving common bus? Samjhan hua? Ke nahi samjhan hua? ओके होप मैं वो समझी लव तुमने समझे बस कंटेंशन अकर व्हेन द टू बस ड्राइव द फोर्स ऑपोजिट लॉजिक वैल्यू इनटू ट्राइस्टेट बफर्स द बस कंटेंशन इज डिजाइन नॉट टू हैपन ड्यूरिंग द नॉर्मल ऑपरेशन सो इट डिजाइन इज सच अ वे दैट इट नेवर हैपन इन द नॉर्मल ऑपरेशन बट इट ड्यूरिंग द बट एंड इन टिपिकल अवॉइडेड ड्यूरिंग द कैप्चर ऑपरेशंस राइट हाउएवर ड्यूरिंग द शिफ्टिंग ऑपरेशन नो सच गारंटी इज हैपनिंग two tri-state buffer are not active simultaneously, right? So it is happened here. These, if I want to load 101, then two D1 and D3 are active simultaneously and creating problems to driving the bus with the two opposite logic. And let me see how, what is the solution of such design when we are converting into a scannable design. So when we convert this such design into a scannable design, we need to be add some extra hardware. These are the extra hardware is added, right? So this extra hardware is it is such a way that it avoid the more than one trusted buffer comes into a active. So how it can be avoided? So it can be avoided like that. Suppose whenever the shift enable is equal to 1, so when the shift enable is equal to 1, whenever it operate in a shifting mode, right? And in the only in a shifting mode we want to avoid the trusted buffer, more than one trusted buffer goes into the active state, right? So when shift enable is equal to 1, this is given to the not. So here it will get 0, here will get 0, and here it will be the 1, right? So one of the input of this AND gate is 0, so this is always 0. So this 2, enable 2 and enable 3, both is equal to 0. So this D3 and D2 and D3 never goes into the active. Only the D1 will have an active state. So only the input of D1 which drive this bus, which is going to drive the bus. So whatever the problems of when the bus is drive by the two opposite logic, that never happened when we put this extra logic with the ending with the shift enable line. And whenever it's operating in normal, so when suppose if I want to operate in normal, shift enable is equal to 0. So output of this enable EN2, that is depending on the another input, right? And that is that we want as per the normal design. So at that time the enable signal, it depends on the other input of the logic gate, and that we want should happen for the normal design. So it satisfied the for the normal design, it is and for the shifting mode, it two enable signal never comes there same. So that's why we can avoid the bus tri-state bus condition problems in a shifting mode. Is it clear? Any questions in this? How it can be avoid the tri-state bus problem?
Okay. No,
next,
sir.
Yeah. Next is the bidirectional I/O port. Next design is in which we need to be taken care when we convert into this scan cell is bidirectional I/O port. If the design have the bidirectional I/O port, so here you can see this is a bidirectional I/O port. Bidirectional I/O port, right? So this I/O port can be drive through this tri-state buffer, right? So when this tri-state buffer is 1, this BO is transferred to the output. So this is driving this work as an output port, and when tri-state buffer is equal to 0, then it is in high impedance. It means it is working as an open switch. At that time this this work as an input, and it driving the BI. It is driving the BI. So this is a bi-directional I/O port. Right. Now when we convert such design in which it have the bi-directional I/O port into a scannable design, then we have to see it should this bidirectional I/O port we have to control such a way that in a shifting mode it should not work as a bidirectional, either it should in a output port or input port. Okay. So we have to restrict the bidirectional I/O port, because this Q which when we operate in a shifting mode, this Q is not a output of the D flip flop. This we have to, this Q it is an input of this SI, and that we want to give the input of another scan cell. We want to create a chain of such scan cells. Since the output value of scan cell can vary during the shifting operation, the output tri-state buffer may become the active, and resulting in a conflict if the B0 and I0 port driven by the tester having the opposite logic value, B0 and the I0. So suppose this is applied in a shifting mode, it is in active, then this B0 also driving this I here, and this I0 also driving, so two opposite logic it's comes in a line. So how we can avoid this bidirectional I/O port problems when we convert into the scan design is that can be avoided using ending shift enable with the output, right? So shift enable that complement of shift enable, inverter of shift enable is ending with the output, it can avoid the this bi-directional I/O problem. How we can, let's see. So whenever we want to operate in a shifting mode, so at that time SE is equal to 1, which make the one of the input of AND gate is 0, which make the output of AND gate is 0. That means this is in a high impedance state, and it's always work in a this I/O always work as an input mode, right? Input mode. Now when we want to operate in a normal mode, so in a normal mode when we give the SC is equal to 0, here it will be the 1, and then output of AND gate depend on the Q, and that we want, right? So at that time it's operate as a normal bidirectional I/O port as per the value of the Q. But in a shifting mode, it's always a disable. So that's where we can avoid the bidirectional I/O port problems in a scan design. Third is the gated clock. So as I explained you what is the gated clock, and the advantage of gated clock in a synchronous design is to reduce the power consumptions by avoiding the unnecessary transition in the gate in clock signal, right? So this is the gated clock logic which generates the enable signal, and that is ending with this AND. So here we'll get the gated clock. So suppose this is a clock. If we have applied like this, and this is one of the signal of this AND gate, and another is a clock enable signal. Suppose clock enable signal is like this. So during this, when the clock enable is equal to 1, so if we draw the gated clock signal, we'll get these types of clock when the clock enable is equal to 1. Right? So this DFF clock is a gated clock, which is not a normal clock. Here the clock for this DFF clock 1 and 2 have the normal clock, and for the DFF clock 3 clock is the gated clock. So all the different flip-flop have the different clock. So when we convert into a scannable design, then our aim is to operate all the flip-flop should operate through a single clock. Then it is a synchronous design. Then it create a shift in, shift out, shift register, scan chain. So we have to avoid to operate all this design with the different clock. So how we can avoid it? So by avoiding is, if we have this clock enable continuously 1, then we'll get the gated clock is equal to the clock, right? So whenever C enable is equal to 1, it create a gated clock signal is equal to the clock, right? So how we can make this clock enable is equal to 1 by keeping the in a testing mode or in a shifting mode by giving this, this is ending with the enable signal. So in a testing and shifting mode, this is equal to 1, which make the output of OR gate is permanent 1, and this will make the clock enable is equal to 1. So we'll get the gated clock is equal to clock during the testing mode and during the shifting mode. And during the normal mode, this 2 is equal to 0, which make the output of OR gate, it is equal to the enable signal that we want as per the design. So here we'll get the clock enable is as per the enable, and clock gated is also as per the enable and as per the this clock gating logic. And in shifting mode and timing, the testing mode, this clock gating logic is bypassed through this OR gate. So we can avoid the gated clock during the shifting and the testing operation. Is it clear what is the problems and how it can be avoided? First of all, it is very much important to understand what is the problem. Why we are doing this, that It is very much important to understand. Solution is easy. Third is the derived clock. Derived clock means it is derived from some logic, right? So you can see here the clock for the D flip flop 1 is a direct clock, right? And clock for the D flip flop 2 and D flip flop 3, it is a derived clock from the D flip flop 1. So it is a ICK. It is a derived from the D flip flop 1. So here the clock for the D flip flop 1 and 2 and 3 is a different. So when we convert such a design into a scannable design, and in scannable design requirement is clock should be same to all the scan cell, because need to be we have to create a shift in shift out shift register. So when we create when we want to create shift in shift out shift register, then requirement is it should be a synchronous design, means the it should be triggered simultaneously. All the storage elements should be triggered the simultaneously. So clock is same, need to be give the same to all the DRAM clocks. And when we convert directly such derived clock type design into a scan cell design just by adding the DRAM clock 2x1 marks, then will not get a same clock to all the DRAM clocks in the design, right? So that is the problem when it have the derived clock. Now, how can we avoid the problem that we'll see later? So how we can avoid the problem? So here you can see the problem can be avoided by putting 2x1 mux, right? So when we operate in a testing mode, then this 2x1 mux select this clock as an clock to the another D flip flop 2 and 3. And when we operate in a normal mode, and when we want a derived clock in a normal mode, our design is such a way that it want a derived clock, right? So at that time it select this port 0 for the clock for the D flip flop 1 and D flip flop 2. So at that time in a normal mode it's have the different clock for the D flip flop, and in a testing and shifting mode this design this all the flip flops in the design have the same clock. So the derived clock logic based design, once we convert into this scannable design, need to be put one extra 2x1 mux which select in a testing mode it select the normal clock, in a normal mode it select the that derived clock, right? Next one is the combinational feedback loop. So combinational feedback loop itself create a sequential circuit. So any feedback in a combinational logic is nothing but a sequential circuit. So how can we avoid the combinational feedback loop? So by putting the extra logic, you can see here in a normal mode when TM is equal to 0, it select this S as a port and it create a loop. So it happened. But when we operate in a testing mode, testing is equal to 1, it select this Q port, and if we in shifting mode, this select the SI, it is in normal mode, it select the DA to the input, and that is an out, right? So by putting this extra logic, we can convert a combinational feedback loop design into a scannable design. Next is the synchronous signal. Synchronous set and reset signal. Asynchronous set and reset signal. So asynchronous signal means it not dependent on the clock, right? So it directly set or reset the output without the waiting of the clock positive edge, right? So this is called asynchronous set and reset signal. So once we convert, if the, our design having a asynchronous set and reset signal, and when we want to convert such design into a scannable design by inserting the DFT logic, then that we can avoid that asynchronous reset. So here you can see this asynchronous signal, it is generated from the D flip flop 1, right? So D flip flop 1 output is set or reset the D flip flop 2. So it is dependent on the D flip flop 1. So when we want to operate in a shifting mode, it should not happen like this. Otherwise, we cannot load the correct data into a shift register. So we should avoid to making the next flip flop should not be set or reset through the any output from the previous flip flop. So this is the requirement for the normal designing. But when we insert for scan cell or when for the testing purpose, we should avoid set or resetting through the output of another flip flop. So we can avoid it. Solution is very simple. And whenever it's operating in a testing mode, it is bypass to reset this next flip flops. Then it not dependent on the queue, right? And when the testing mode is equal to one, then it not dependent on queue output of the flip flop one. And when the testing mode is zero, then it is dependent on the queue, right? This in a normal mode. So in a normal mode, testing mode is zero, which make the reset signal dependent on the output of the flip flop one. And in testing mode, it make it independent on the output of D flip flop one. Yes. Any questions? So these are the main different design style which we have covered, and how the we can avoid the problem of in scan designing. Recommended solution. Scan design is widely used. The reason is CAD tool available. The CAD tool convert our design into a scannable design by inserting the DFT logic. We do not have to design a DFT logic for a design. Directly tool itself convert the design into a scannable design. So that the advantage of the scan design DFT technique. And design itself have a different types of such gated clock, derived clock, asynchronous dash set reset. So in that case, we need to be taken care and how to do the solution that also we have seen. Bidirectional I/O port, tri-state buffer. So we have seen this are the different design style, and when we convert into the scannable design, what we have to avoid in a shifting mode, and when we want to avoid in a testing and shifting mode both. Yes. Any questions? Okay. So our this chapter, I think this chapter.